Hello and welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallet and today we're going to look how easy we can make virtualization within our KVM and QEMU system by making use of cloud images. Images that have already been built for us and they come with cloud in it so we can configure them. So we want to show you why using KVM on your Linux system can be better than using something maybe like VirtualBox. Now, VirtualBox is available for Linux, but we're going to show you how easily we can make our configuration by using cloud images and cloud config. So I'm working on an Ubuntu 18.04 system here. I've already got my QEMU and KVM installed, but you may have to install a couple of additional utilities. I have them, but we want to make sure that you also have those utilities. Because we're working with cloud images, we want to make sure that we've got our cloud image tools. So sudo apt installed cloud image utils. And again, you can see, as I've already said, that on my system, this is already installed, but you might have to add it to your system. We'll also be running our installation or import of the image from the command line. It's just easy to demonstrate this way. So again, you might have to add in virt-install. So apt install virt-inst. So say both of these packages I already have. The next thing is to get our pre-built image. And we'll work, let's say, with an Ubuntu image. So we can use wget and just search for cloud images Ubuntu. And it will take you through to cloudimagesubuntu.com. You can choose the image that you want. Again, I've already downloaded this, so I won't be downloading it on this system, but it doesn't take too long to download, obviously dependent on the speed that you have to the superhighway of the internet. Now, with that done, we can start looking at how we can make life easy for ourselves. So I'm just going to create a little text file here, so cloud.txt, it really doesn't matter the name, but it must begin with then the hash and cloud dash config exactly as I have here. Now with this we can then start customizing our image. By default these cloud images normally can't be logged into by username and password. We're normally going to have to supply a SSH key. We could do through this file as well, but we want to have a simple username and password login. So we're setting the password for our first user, and on an Ubuntu system that's going to be the user Ubuntu. We also want to make sure that the password doesn't expire, so we can set then the key to password and expire and false. With this done, we can then go through and make sure that we can log on through SSH password authentication, so we can just set this to true. So notice the keys then are delimited from everything else by the colon. And finally, we're just going to show that we can also set the host name. So I'm just going to set this, let's say, to 1604 master. Again, you can set any host name that you want. So once we've got this set and looking vaguely correct, we can go through and save that. We'll need to create an image from this later. And to create the image, which is essentially just going to be an ISO file, we use then cloud local DS. We'll make sure that we're running with sudo because we're going to be writing through to a privileged directory, and that's going to be /var /lib, and then in the libvirt and images subdirectory, and we'll just say call it cloud.image or cloud.iso, whatever you're happy with. And we read in then the cloud.txt, the file that we've just created. So this is the way that we can make use of the cloud init service that's built into our images. If we then go through and copy across the image that we've downloaded, so we're going to use QEMU image convert. It will have actually downloaded as a qcal2 image. So say this really acts as a copy. I think it's a great idea to keep the image that we've downloaded separate from any image that we're working with. So I'm going to keep the image inside my home directory and then use the image convert to copy the file across to the var/libvirt images directory. So you can see then we're reading in the image file that we downloaded, and we're writing out to var/libvirt images, and then we'll call it 1604 master. So once we've got that done, it shouldn't take too long. So essentially, this just becomes a copy of the image. We're then ready to run our virt install. Now, virt install is not necessarily going to be the most friendliest, so you might want to put it into a script. I have it in a script already created if we just cat this out. I'll also put it in the description of the video, so if you want to copy the script, it's going to be available for you. But you can see then that we're running then with sudo the virt install command. We're setting up the name of the virtual machine. That doesn't have to be the same as the host name. It just happens to be in our case. We're using 1 gig of memory. We're connecting those two disks that we created. So our 1604 image and our cloud image. The cloud image is just going in as a CD-ROM though. We're setting the OS type and the OS variant so we can use our KVM acceleration within QEMU. And you can see we're not using graphics, we don't particularly need it, and we're connecting to the default network. And we're doing an import rather than an install, because to all intents and purposes, everything is installed on our image file that we downloaded. So I've already made this script executable, so we can then just go through and execute it. And we can see then the machine now just boots, and we're automatically connected to the serial console of the system. Again, being a cloud image, very often they have the kernel parameters to give you a serial port that you can connect to with the console. And we can see now we've got our host name set, 1604 master, and we've got our login. And remember, we set the password. We didn't set the user account, but it will be Ubuntu, and then the password that we configured. As I say, normally you would not be able to log in with a username and password. You have to use SSH authentication. So we've been able to bypass that and set the host name. So we can start seeing then how useful this can be and how we should consider something like KVM as a virtualization system for us to use. Thank you for watching, and I do look forward to seeing you again on my channel very soon.